Good morning, friends. Welcome to Sharekhan Free Market Roundup. Firstly, on the global markets, when our market closed yesterday, most of European markets are trading in green bar on 1.5 to 2% across the board, whereas the American markets, that is the Dow Jones and Nasdaq futures, were showing a positive opening bar on 0.2 to 0.3% for American markets. Finally, by the end of the day, European markets closed up by around 2 to 2.5% across the board. DAX was in fact up by around 2.7%. Whereas the American markets, by the end of the day, closed on a flattish note, with the Dow Jones being up around 10 to 12 points and Nasdaq almost flattish, with S&P in red. Coming back to our markets, yesterday we saw some volatility in our market. At one point of time, Nifty opened up around 40 points. From there on, it went into negative by around 5 to 6 points. But finally, we managed to end the session by around 30 points higher on Nifty and around 100 points higher on Sensex. FIIs yesterday were seller by 492 crore rupees in cash market, whereas FIIs in index futures were seller by 139 crore rupees. Domestic institutional investors were buy around 790 crore rupees in cash market. Now let's hear an update on derivatives.
Good morning, friends. We will give analysis on derivatives. In yesterday's market, taking positive cues from the international markets, our market also opened on a gap up of around 30-40 odd points. But later it found difficult to sustain at higher levels, and we have seen some kind of a selling pressure in mid part of the day. But however, in the last 1 hour of trade, we have seen Nifty took resilience at lower level at around 7,800, and Nifty found good amount of support. And thereon, we have seen a sharp pullback in yesterday's trade, due to which we managed to close only 0.32% higher at 7852.60. Now the open interest terms again an unwinding of around 0.5%, that is around 1.28 lakh shares were shedded in open interest. The cost of carry did decrease from 9.5% to 7.5%, that is Nifty premium did came down from 21 odd points to currently 15 points. However, we will consider majority of the unwinding which took place in yesterday's trade was on the short covering side. And put call ratio have inched a bit higher, but it still remains at a very low level. We have seen in 1 basis point uptick in put call ratio from 0.71 to 0.72. And since put call ratio anywhere around 0.7075, would always consider as an oversold territory for the Nifty, and Nifty continues to be in the oversold territory. According to the derivatives parameter, and the Indian volatility index have decreased significantly in yesterday's trade by 6% from 17.88 to 16.97 levels. Now the options activity, 7,900 call option have seen minor addition of around 1%, while 8,000 call option have seen an addition of around 2%. Not major activity was seen in options in yesterday's trade. The interesting observation was 7,700 put option, which is the highest in terms of open interest for the put strike price, and has seen an reduction of 3.5% and it's highest in terms of open interest with around 57 lakh shares in it. While 7,800 put option have seen an addition of around 10% in yesterday's trade. So all in all, seeing the futures open interest in the options activity, market has been on the market have crossed the VWAP in yesterday's trade of around 7830 and was able to sustain. And I was able to give clues about its VWAP now. Today's main focus would be the VWAP of around 7,800, which was yesterday's low. So unless and until 7,800 and 7,820 has been hold on in today's trade, we might see a continuation in the uptrend in the further trading session. So watch out our VWAP level of 7,820 quite closely in today's trade. There is only one securities in bank period for today's trade, that is Jindal Steel. While on the FIIs activity, they continue to be on the selling side. In index futures, they were net sellers by 138 crores, while index options, they were net buyers of 945 crores. In stock futures, they were net sellers by 181 crores, and stock options, they were net sellers by 75 crores only. Now, I suggested for our market level, our 5 days VWAP stands at 7820, which would be in a focus in today's trade, with the lower range at 7800 and higher range at 7950. SX Nifty is trading negative by 20 points. SX Nifty has been suggesting a negative opening can be expected in today's trade, as it's quoting at 7828. That's it from derivatives. Thank you.
Now let's have a look at some trading ideas for the day. The first idea is Tata Motors. Tata Motors is looking to launch 5 new products by 2019. The company is also looking to adopt a new passenger vehicle strategy to boost sales, in which they won't be giving the passenger vehicles for commercial use. action to be taken in Tata Motors, long Tata Motors with a stop at 399 for a target of 419 and 427. There was a news for aviation sector yesterday. CCI has fined IndiGo, Jet and SpiceJet for cancellation. Fine for Jet Airways is 151.7 crore rupees, IndiGo is 63.74 crore rupees and SpiceJet is 42.48 crore rupees. Action to be taken here is short Jet Airways with a stop at 437 for a target of 416 and 407 and short SpiceJet with a stop at 48.9 for a target of 46.5 and 45.5. Eros Media is the next idea. Eros International PLC has reported numbers yesterday. Revenue was up 98% and at 98.8 million versus 49.9 million. Eros International PLC adjusted EBITDA at plus 159.5% at 36 million versus 13.9 million YOY. The stock in the Eros International PLC stock was up around 15 to 18% at one point of time. Action to be taken here is long Eros Media with stop at 199.8 for a target of 210.14. On some of the important news flow which flowed in yesterday was 7th Pay Commission to submit report on November 20th. Average hike of 15% is expected. It's a positive read through for auto sector, FMCG and consumer discretionary. Policy on coal linkages is likely in next 15 days time as per government sources. Government is expected to finalize a fair and investor friendly policy for auctioning exploration blocks within the remaining period of the current fiscal. IBSL to get 400 crore rupees from sale of three road projects. Maharashtra government is looking not to seek a fresh ban on Maggi in Supreme Court, positive on Nestle. GSK Pharma has stepped up its focus on its vaccine business with a price cut in its top selling pneumonia vaccine. Persistent Systems to acquire CMS business of US based Apuminya. MEP Infrastructure has bagged two toll collections contracts. Off-takers of Reliance Power 4,000 megawatt Tilaya UMPP, that is Ultra Mega Power Project in Jharkhand, have agreed to terminate their PPAs and that is power purchase agreements and compensate our power for cost and bank guarantees aggregating close to 914 crore rupees. As per RBI, FIS can now invest up to 12% and analyze up to 2% power defense. With rupees 170 crore net worth eroding, Nissan and Leyland joint venture company is looking on the way of BIFR doors. Stocks with positive bias are Cadila Healthcare in Bharti Infratel and CEAT. Stocks with negative bias are Indiabulls Housing Finance, CESC and Hexaware. Stocks for investment are Aditya Birla Numo, Britannia, Maruti, HDFC Bank and Zee. That's all friends from our side. Thanks for my mastering session.